Grant, over under is done now. So how do you think it went? It's over. How do you think it went?
I guess it is. I guess it is.
I think they know.
I think over under was probably one of my favorite games. It wasn't a water game, so I guess it wasn't like perfect, apparently. Now, my thing with over-under, it was one of the fierce games. Remember, I mentioned to Abby that the community was really always looking or has been asking for games that, you know, evolve over time. And it's a really big challenge for us from a game design perspective to figure out, you know, how that could work. And that was one of my favorite things about over-under. Strategy totally changed as the season went on. We first revealed it, everybody's like, it's not disc shooting, it's not super call climbing or anything, like it's not super flashy. And I said, no, it's gonna be strategic, it's a good driver's game, and I love how the overall season, you know, journey went.
Absolutely, strategy became the name of the game. And you know, Grant, since it's over, would you have done anything different?
You mean like if I got to design another game?
Let's say there was another game on its way, what might you have done?
So, over-under was good. It had a climbing endgame. I think it probably could have gone a little higher.
Higher?
I think it could have involved some more risk-taking, some more like opportunities for, you know, heavy offensive defense.
Okay.
I think you know what time it is, Tyler.
Yeah, try and go further. Try and go farther than ever without a burner. Feeling like I never quit moving, I am a learner. And learn that the higher you get, they want to earn you. But I gotta keep moving. I know what the mission is. Eye on the prize, man, I know what the vision is. Shoot for the sky, you aim high, you blow it. Never take no for an answer, keep going, just breathe. Just breathe.
Ladies and gentlemen, high stakes. Let's find out how high stakes is played.
Welcome to the 2024-2025 VEX V5 Robotics Competition and this year's game, High Stakes. Let's take the stage. High Stakes is played on a 12-foot by 12-foot field by two alliances, one red and one blue, made up of two teams each. The game's primary scoring object is a plastic ring. Rings have an outer diameter of 7 inches, an inner diameter of 3 inches, and a thickness of 2 inches. There are 48 rings on the field, 24 red and 24 blue. There are also 5 hexagonal mobile goals that can be used by either alliance. Mobile goals have a maximum diameter of 10 inches and an overall height of 14.5 inches. Points are scored by placing an alliance's rings onto 1-inch PVC pipes called stakes. There are 10 stakes located around the field. 5 stakes that are part of the mobile goals, which can fit 6 rings each, 2 wall stakes, which can also fit 6 rings each, 2 alliance wall stakes, which can fit 2 rings each, and 1 high stake on top of the ladder, which can only fit 1 ring. Rings that are scored on stakes are worth 1 point for that ring's alliance. The highest ring on each stake is called the top ring, and is worth 2 additional points. Matches begin with a 15-second autonomous period, where robots operate without input from their drivers. Robots begin with 1 ring as a preload and must stay on their side of the autonomous line. Alliances also have the opportunity to earn an autonomous win point by completing a certain set of tasks during the autonomous period. The 1 minute 45-second driver control period begins once the autonomous bonus winner has been determined. In high stakes, object possession is limited to 2 rings and 1 mobile goal. However, rings that are scored on stakes do not count towards this limit. And rings can be de-scored from any neutral stake, at any time. At the end of the match, robots can earn additional points by climbing the 4-foot-tall ladder. Using the first bar of the ladder to get your robot off the ground is considered a level 1 climb and is worth 3 points. Passing the first bar gets you to a level 2 climb and is worth 6 points. Getting the entire robot above the second bar is considered a level 3 climb and is worth 12 points. Note that the ladder has 4 sides, but there are no alliance-specific climbing locations. Robots may climb up any side that they want. One more thing. At any point during the match, mobile goals can be placed into the 4 corners of the field, which will modify the scores of both alliances. 2 of them are positive corners. If a mobile goal is placed in a positive corner, all rings scored on that mobile goal will have their point values doubled. The other 2 are negative corners. When a mobile goal is placed into a negative corner, all rings that are scored on that mobile goal will effectively be changed to negative point values. They are now worth 0 points and remove an equivalent amount of points from the Alliance's other scored rings. High stakes can also be played in Robot Skills Challenges, where one team competes against the clock, and the collegiate level Vex U Robotics Competition, where teams design 2 robots using advanced materials. Check out the game manual or talk to your REC Foundation representative for all the details. Official rules and game information for high stakes can be found at recf.org or vexrobotics.com. To register a team, find events near you, or ask a question on the official Q&A, please visit robotevents.com. Best of luck, and have a great 2024-2025 season.
There it is. High stakes, y'all. So this is the part of the show when I normally come out here and say, like, oh, I'm so excited about this game. We're doing stuff we've never done before. It's crazy. A few of you probably picked up on it. Anybody in the crowd compete during the roundup season? So one of the questions we get asked sometimes is, you ever think about redoing games? We, for this game, our core concept, we wanted to take a game from the pre-V5 era, from the Cortex era, and modernize it, and basically see what these V5 robots could do, and make it as intense as possible. So we've got the mobile goals. Mobile goals, as described in the video, neutral on all around. One of the major improvements we attempted to make over Roundup is it's a lot easier to score them than it is to de-score them, but it's not impossible. The stakes are flexible rubber, so to get the ring off of the mobile goal, you do kind of have to like manipulate it off. So I'll show you straight in here. The ring actually has to like pop over it in order to be scored. So that's one. Expansion limits are another question I keep getting asked. We did something a little bit different in this game. You're gonna have to read the rules to get all the details. But if you picture a typical Vex robot is, you know, roughly square shaped, you can only expand out of one side of your robot up to a certain number of inches. We're not allowing expansion in any direction. So that's an interesting one. Changing the game mid-season is another question. The way we're going to be doing it in high stakes is that the Auton win point is going to be more challenging at events which qualify for the World Championship. So SIG events, state championships, national championships, will have a more challenging Auton win point. And again, more details in the manual to be released later in the year, yada yada. We also have, of course, the single tallest climbing element that a Vex robot has ever had to climb before, 4 feet tall. And of course, my favorite part, a doubler and a true negator corner. You thought over-under had crazy defense. I can't wait to see 2 teams battling over that corner. I really, really wanted to see partner climbing in over-under. I really wanted to see robots lifting robots in over-under, and you guys just didn't deliver. So in high stakes, for VexU competitors only, any robot which is elevated and not contacting the ladder has their climb points doubled. All the details are going to be in the manual, which DRAW is live right now. So go check it out, vex.com. Get the manual for high stakes, and I will see you all later. Tyler, take us home. No,